much the point I'm trying to get across is, God, I need to sit up straight. Okay, the point I'm trying to get across is that I just feel like my face looks more put together, or I look more of myself when my eyebrows are filled, but I'm now just trying to grow my eyebrows in, which is another reason why I stopped waxing. And I'm just kind of really babysitting my eyebrows. And I know the desired look that I want. So when I go in to groom my eyebrows, I make sure I keep that in mind. And I mean, most of the time, if you're cleaning up, you're gonna get all those extra hairs under your eyebrow. But for me, I leave a lot of those in and just kind of pluck random little stray hairs that aren't in that line or in that pattern that, or in that path that I want eventually. So as far as the tools that I use, it's nothing too crazy. I go in with a tweezer. Typically, you definitely wanna go with a sharper tip like that, just cause it helps you pick at those hairs a lot easier and you're not picking at your skin. And then I also use little scissors. These came in like a manicure kit. They're also stainless steel. They're very sharp and it works perfect because it snips exactly where I want and then it doesn't cause any drag or pull on my eyebrow hairs. So those are the two tools that I use. And then of course I always have a spoolie brush. Spoolie brushes are definitely a need. Just a flat angled brush. And I'll use that sometimes if I wanna like fill in with powder or something, I'll use that other end for that. But these are the tools that I typically use. And then of course, you're gonna wanna go and find you an eyebrow pencil. This is just a random drugstore pencil. It's a Maybelline brow definer pencil. One end is like that. So get yourself an eyebrow pencil, drugstore, luxury brand, whatever you want to use, it'll work. And then sometimes this Naked Basics palette, I know it's really rough. Sometimes I'll go in with the brown shade in here. If I'm wanting like a sleeker look or a sharper look, I'll go in with some brow powder. No, I'm sorry, some eyeshadow powder, this angled brush, and then some sort of either finishing spray or like a MAC Fix Plus, and I'll just go in and wet it and apply it that way, but. Okay, so first thing when it comes to maintaining your eyebrows is you wanna get a good look at what you're working with. I probably cleaned my eyebrows not too long ago, so there isn't gonna be that much I need done, but I could kind of just show you like a general idea of what I do. So first I'll take this spoolie brush and then I'll go ahead. Hold on, let me get a little bit lower. Okay, so I'll take this spoolie brush and I'll just go ahead and brush through my eyebrows and see what hairs stick out. There's a few hairs over here. And so just an FYI, I'm trying to grow this middle piece out a little bit so I don't really pluck too much when it comes to my middle section of my eyebrows, or my, what do you call this? Inner corner of my eyebrow? I don't know. What do you call this? The innards of my eyebrows. Okay. So when it comes to this part of my eyebrow, I don't really tweeze too much because I'm trying to grow it in. And I guess typically the rule of thumb, and I mean, you could Google this, look it up on YouTube, any tutorial or video is gonna tell you, the rule of thumb is you wanna find where, like just take like any brush like this. Let's see if I have something thinner. So let's try with this. So I'm going to hold it next to the bridge of my nose, and then I'm going to just kind of follow and see where that meets. And as you can see, exactly where that points to is where my hair is a bit sparse. So that is what I'm trying to grow out. And then the same with the other side, you're just going to hold it straight up, see where it meets. And there's just a little bit of space right here. And I mean, it's really, it's not a big deal. I could fill it in easily, but that's just, you know, where I want my natural hairs to grow and fall, just so it fits the shape of my face. And then as far as the angles or where your arches are gonna be, you're supposed to take any brush again, and then you're just gonna kind of hold it along the side of your nose, and you're gonna let it go here. You're gonna hold it through the side of your nose, and then you're gonna follow it through the middle of your pupil, and exactly where it meets at the top is where you want that arch to be. So technically mine is supposed to be about here. And as you can see, there's not much of an arch to that part of my eyebrow, but that's kind of what I'm trying to grow in. I'm trying to grow this part of my eyebrow in a little bit up here. So then that way I could start removing a little bit and create that arch. And then on this side, I do the same thing. Goes through the center of my eye. Oh, hold on, this side. Goes through the center of my eye, and then where it meets here, and that's kind of where I started forming my arch a little bit here. And then as far as the tail end, it's gonna be the side of your nose and the outer part of your eye. And you're gonna just hold it there. And my tail end here, it's about there. There's a little bit. I'm trying to get that to grow in here. And then on this side, right on the outer corner of your eye, it's about perfect. So, like I said, I've been growing my eyebrows out for, oh gosh, I don't know. I would say like 4 or 5 years. And that's not to scare anyone. It's just, it's a process. Some people's eyebrows grow faster than others. Some people's hair grow faster than others. I didn't put anything on my eyebrows to help them grow. So I'm sure if I did put something, some sort of oils or something, it probably would have helped me grow. I don't really take any vitamins either. So I'm sure that would help with the process also. I'll list some things down in the description box as far as like natural oils and stuff that you could put on your eyebrows just to help that growing process if you are looking to thicken your eyebrows. If not, then ignore everything I just said and go ahead and fast forward to where we're about to maintain. So, back to maintaining. We are going to just go ahead and brush my eyebrows in the direction that they grow. And then I'm going to just kind of look and see if there are any hairs sticking out, which there are a few hairs right here. So I'm just gonna go ahead and grab those. And make sure when you're tweezing that you're pulling the hair in the direction that your hair is growing. So, you know, like your eyebrow hair is growing this way, that way. So when you have the hair in the tweezer, you just wanna make sure you're pulling that way. You don't wanna tug it anywhere. It'll hurt more than you might think it already does. And then two, it's gonna leave, I mean, it could leave some marks and a hole, like holes around your eyebrows, and you don't want that, so. When you tweeze your eyebrows, just make sure you're going in the direction that your hair grows. And I'm just gonna look around my eyebrows, see if there are any hairs sticking out. And make sure in between you're clearing any of the hair that may be in your eyebrows, because it's hard to grasp. And I catch myself pinching my skin a lot after not cleaning, you know, off some of the hairs. Just because it's harder to grab that hair and it slips and then you'll nick yourself sometimes. So just make sure your eyebrows or your tweezers are clean. And this one is going to be a pain in my butt. All right, false alarm. It wasn't a hair. It's just like a little freckle or something, so. Yeah. All right, and then I'm gonna go ahead and do the same to the other side. This eyebrow is a little bit different. As you can see, my eyebrow shapes are a lot different. This eyebrow is a little bit thicker and it comes up higher. This arch is a little bit higher, and then this one sits a little bit lower and that arch is just barely there. So what I'm trying to do is grow, you know, this part out. And then I'm also trying to just grow like a little bit in here just to get that a little bit thicker. So when I tweeze this eyebrow, I make sure I just stay on this like outer corner here mostly, and then down here if there's any stray hairs. But I typically leave this space alone just so I can grow that in. All right, and then once you get underneath, I'm just gonna go ahead and brush this hair down. I don't do too much with this side of the eyebrow because it's about at the height that I want it, but there are a few stray hairs that I'll pick up here. And then on this side, I don't really do anything at all with the top part, but I will clean up this side over here a little bit. All right, so once I get a lot of the hair out of the way, the next step is gonna be kind of trimming my eyebrow hairs. This step you definitely wanna be careful with. You can cut too much off. So first, as far as like from the middle in, I'm gonna brush the hair upwards. And then any hair that's kind of sticking up, like those hairs right there, a little bit right there, I'm gonna go ahead and trim. Using the scissors, I'm going in this way. It's just easier to grasp the hairs coming in this way than trying to cut the other way. So I'm just gonna go in, carefully snip those hairs that are just kind of sticking up. And then on the outer corner and the tail end of my eyebrows, I'm just going to brush down. And the same thing, whatever is sticking out underneath, I'm just gonna go ahead and trim that. And then brush it back, see what you're working with. Well, then back to the inner part of my eyebrow, I'm just gonna tweeze a little bit of the hairs in the middle. And then as far as trimming, I'm gonna do the same on this eyebrow, and then we will move on to filling them in. All right, and once you have your eyebrows all trimmed, just, you know, make sure there's no extra stray hairs anywhere. And then next, I'm going to go and fill in my eyebrows and brush your hairs up. And that is going to allow you to really to see where you want to apply your first line or your outline of your eyebrow. So I just always brush this up. Then I'm gonna go in with my pencil. You could start from any part of your eyebrow. I typically start from about right here just because you don't want to press too hard or apply too hard on the inner corner or else it won't look very natural. So I'm gonna start here and I'm just gonna go ahead and fill in my desired eyebrow shape on the bottom. All right, and then once you get that bottom line how you want it, I'm gonna go ahead, brush my eyebrow hairs down. Just gonna start at the very top, and I'm going to do light brush strokes. I'm not gonna draw it in like I did with that bottom line. I only did it with the bottom line because it was just kind of the base for everything. When I apply the lines on the top or fill it in, I'm always gonna use like a light brush stroke with my hands. So. And then once you get that line in, I'm gonna go back through the middle, and any spots that are kind of sparse or there's not really too much hair, I'm gonna go ahead and just apply those light brush. All right, and then once you get all of that filled in, I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna do upwards brush strokes here and just kind of fill in a little bit here. I'm gonna start that first stroke where I want that hair to grow in, and yeah, so. All right, and then once I get that filled in, I'm gonna take my spoolie brush and I'm just gonna brush through, make sure everything is even throughout the hairs. Like so. And then I'm gonna do the same thing on this eyebrow. And now since this eyebrow shape is a little different, I kind of treat it a little differently. Also, when I go in on this bottom line here, I'm gonna do it a little bit thicker just to kind of give the appearance that these are, you know, at the same height. And then also when I go in through the top here, I'm gonna do the same and just apply it a little bit higher and a little bit thicker just so it matches that other side. And there you go. Also, your eyebrows are probably not gonna look identical, which is okay. My eyebrows do not look identical. Just remember your eyebrows are sisters, not twins. They're not even fraternal twins. They're just sisters. Sometimes they got different daddies. So don't stress about them being identical. Most people's face isn't completely symmetrical anyways. So everything isn't going to look exactly the same across your face. So I really wouldn't worry about that too much. I'm gonna go ahead and finish the rest of my eyes and I will be right back. All right guys, well, that is my little walkthrough of how, I don't even know if you call it a walkthrough, like what? That is my little show and tell step through. I don't know, I'll figure it out. But I hope you enjoyed that little tutorial. I know I rambled a little bit, but hopefully as I continue posting videos and making more videos, I will get more comfortable in front of the camera and just things go a lot smoother. And let me know what you think. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please do. I really appreciate it. If you are already subscribed to my channel, thank you so much. It means the world to me. And let me know in the comments what you think. I love to hear feedback. Let me know what you want to see, what you want me to talk about, review. I kind of want to open my channel to you guys and let this just kind of be stuff that you want to see, talk about, like I said, review. So just let me know and stay tuned for my next video coming very soon.